today I'm going to be giving you guys a little tutorial on how I edited and colored some of the recent Kyle visualizers.
First of all, you can kind of see when I de-click the layers here, I pretty much color always inside of Adobe Premiere with an adjustment layer. And I use my adjustment layer so that my videos have an overall cohesive look and color. Here you can see this is all the raw footage shot on Super 8 millimeter film. That film comes in a very flat look. It's not colored whatsoever. So I apply the adjustment layer over my whole timeline and I add Lumetri color and then levels. You can see when I click those on and off what it looks like. Here's the final color, just a very clean, crunchy film look. So if I'm diving into the Lumetri color here, I'm gonna take you into the creative tab. That's where I always apply a LUT. And here you can see I have the Tropicolor Archive LUT set to 40%. I chose the 40% look just because I wanted something that was a little more subtle that I would dial in the levels with later. But you can see when I skim through the intensity, how you can take a LUT to a more stronger effect or lighten the effect. But Tropicolor Archive 40% here for this particular look. In here, I didn't actually mess with the color wheels. I pretty much left it as is with the simple LUT from Tropicolor. From here, I dive into the levels. This is where I can do a lot of really cool stuff. So you can see here without the levels, the black input level set to zero, it's pretty flat. In this case, I took it up to about 80, 75%. I don't know if percent is the right term as much as it is the number. Then with the white input level, taking down that a notch to about 225, brightens those whites a little bit, gives it a little more pop so it doesn't feel as flat. Gamma, I took that down from 100 to about 90 to give it a little, you know, a little more dark texture. The black output, and these are just the bottom layers, are just a little fine tuning to give it a little more warmth. That gamma down at the bottom, drag it below 100 a little bit. But you can see on and off toggle, that's quite the difference from the flat look before. If I take all of those off, there's the look before, and then with my LUT and levels adjusted, there's the look after. Pretty stark difference, night and day. And then I did add a little border as well there. So like a little film mat border to really draw your attention in. And that's it.